Farad has a question here. Big industry claims they are there to meet the ever-growing demand for food supplies. What do we offer as a foundation for our arguments that we can do the same better? How long would it take to start feeding the world if transformed wholesale to permaculture today? What would the transformation cost humanity? Would there be a sacrifice involved? Well, we could do it very quickly, probably 6 months, if less, and there would be no sacrifice. It'd only be benefit. We'd have healthier food. We'd have less pollution. And we're a world that would be continuously repairing with overabundance. Every food demand? What does that mean? A growing demand for food supplies? Industrial agriculture doesn't provide us with anywhere near the diversity that we can produce ourselves. Urban agriculture, perimeter urban agriculture, with rangeland and forestry outside of that. Urban agriculture produces hundreds of times more food per square meter and more diversity and more nutrient density with less pollution and creates soil and ecology at the same time. All we've got in industrial agriculture is convenient exploitation of the earth for money, right? With no quality food. It's all very, very low nutrient density, and we have enormous amounts of pollutant inputs and enormous amount of transport costs and very little employment. Everything we have going for us when we switch to urban agriculture and perimeter urban agriculture, rangeland and forestry outside of there. Forestry is very long-term yield. That it can be transported into town easily because of the length of time between the yield. Rangeland, animals can be walked into town for process. Perimeter urban agriculture is running on the waste streams and runoff from town and employs everybody that needs to be employed and creates a very diverse product. And urban agriculture, the micro agriculture, the small scale agriculture produces so much more than any agricultural industrial system. It's ridiculous. It's not even on the same scale. If you go to the nutrition that's produced, not just the weight of the food, because industrial agriculture specializes in producing low nutritional weight. So, well, most of the crops have been speciated or genetically engineered to produce a lot of weight, but not a lot of nutrition. So you have to buy more to get the same amount of nutrition. If you look at the urban agricultural classic sites of the world, the production per square meter, that the equivalent per acre, deep green permaculture in a Mediterranean climate in Melbourne, 13 and a half tons per acre per year, equivalent on 64 square meters. The Path to Freedom, Pasadena, Los Angeles, and their production per square meter. HappyEarth.com in Australia. There are many places where if you look at the food that's produced in a small area, the diversity, the weight, but also the diversity and the nutrient density and the lack of chemical inputs, the lack of toxic inputs, all organic, and the lack of transport for that food to get to the end user, and the lack of wastage in the system. Industrial agriculture has massive amounts of inputs, massive amounts of energy, massive amounts of transport, very low production per square meter, and huge transport costs because it's usually grown out of scale on a large area and transported to the populations. There's no contest. And if you want to put nutrition in there, there's no contest. So there's no sacrifice. We all get meaningful employment as well. We all get better nutrition. We all get better health. We all get better psychological benefits because we all feel more secure. Everything about it is better. The switch is just a conscious switch. We just switch over and stop using that system and then it goes broke. We don't need it. We just don't need it at all. We can produce the same amount of nutrition on 4% of the equivalent land surface area presently used by industrial agriculture by repositioning it around inside a population, around populations, and in the surrounding landscape on the outside of that perimeter. Let me repeat that. It's 4%, and 96% can can just disappear. We don't need to use it. But we don't need the same land. All that land, those large blank landscapes with simplistic monoculture, totally unnatural systems at a great distance. We don't need that. I'm saying 4 to 6% of the equivalent area repositioned inside and around populations and on the surrounding landscape of that perimeter. That's what we need to do. And as we do that, the rest of that industrial agricultural landscape becomes insignificant. And let's not measure food, let's measure nutrition. When someone like Eric Tozemeyer, who wrote the great book, Permaculture Lot, in Holyoke, Massachusetts, that gets 2 foot of snow every year, researched on 1,000 square meters growing 300 perennial food crops, 300, not annuals, but perennials, not the annuals, the perennial food crops, where there's 2 foot of snow every year, and then settled on the best 200. And half of that doesn't get sold in our shops. Half of that's not available to us. How much extra quality of food is there? Even then you can process it, you can dry it, you can store it, you can ferment it. And then you've got the annuals on top of it. It's no contest. There is no contest. And if we made the switch, we could just do it straight away. And the next season, we could be out of industrial agriculture if we want to. We're just going to make agriculture in its present form, industrial agriculture, that destroys soil and erodes soil and depletes ecosystems and diminishes diversity, all of that stuff should be illegal. It should be illegal, right, to practice industrial agriculture. We don't need it. We never have needed it. It was started with slavery, really. It was when we created slavery, we created slavery agriculture. And then we used technology to replace the slaves. And then we're destroying the world with technology and destructive processes and destructive components. It's very foolish. It's ridiculous activity, actually.